Hey, so today we'll be doing a review on a posable action figure versus the not very posable and very limited articulated Saw Final figures. So I'm not an expert on these kind of like posable toy reviews, so I'm just gonna kind of go through it and talk about what I like about the toy or the anime or whatnot. And yeah, here we go. This is the JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Super Action Statue. WonderFest 2020 Shanghai Limited Edition. Yeah, it's a long series of words. It's made with, it's the same as a regular Super Action statue, except it is made with Swarovski crystals. Or it's not made with Swarovski crystals. They kind of just put these little crystals on them. You can kind of do it yourself. I thought about it afterwards. You can kind of do it yourself at home. And in China, especially, there's actually people you can just kind of hit up to do it. I'm not a very arts and crafts kind of guy. So I wouldn't be doing that, but definitely if you are able to, or if you're really skilled and like, artistically inclined and you're really good at painting your own figures, it's like I'd recommend you just do that instead. So here is Diablo outside of his box and in display. It is very, very nice in person, honestly. I do enjoy the little bedazzles they put on it, and you'd imagine that the head, the exchangeable head, would come with the same kind of like crystal treatment you see on the top here, but no, it does not actually. It's just a regular head with regular colored hair. I actually prefer this alternate head, so that was quite a disappointment when this didn't come with it. I'm pretty sure the other ones don't come with it either. Like the other toys don't come with the alternate head with little bedazzles. The accessories are the same. They're not anything different or more special, or like any nicer than it was with like crystals on it. So yeah, don't expect too much. And it also comes with like this small packet of crystals. I feel like that's not enough. I mean, they're not that expensive. The crystals itself, I bought a Swarovski necklace once, and like they just gave me like a bag of crystals. So I have no idea why it's priced at this range. But pricing wise, this guy is, how much is it? I got it for 2,500 RMB. I think the usual price is 4,000 yen, sorry, 40,000 yen. And I honestly, you'd expect that these guys in the special edition would maybe have more rigorous QC, but you still have that same issue with like misalignments on the details on the body. So, we're like, I guess we call those like fishnet things. There are still issues with it where the lines aren't perfect. I thought maybe these guys would have like a lot better or perfect lining, but it does not seem to be the case. But Diablo is definitely a really cool figure with the bedazzled crystals on them. Just solely because it really reminds me of, my high school era where we had like Ed Hardy and Dahmer Bell, and everyone had these bedazzled t-shirts. You remember that? Yeah, so I feel like this is a very nice figure with that kind of look, especially with the pants. I like that how it's individual. The crystals are in different colors instead of the standard just one color with most of the other Super Action statues in these kind of limited edition run sizes. So this is a run of 100, and Diablo, I think, is one of my favorite characters in Golden Wind. I really hope they came out. I really want them to come out with like a Doppio. But I don't think that will come out in any time soon, maybe in like a decade or two. But I really enjoy Doppio a lot more, or at least they just gave us like an alternate Doppio head. That would be super cool. Unfortunately, that's not the case. So here we are with Diablo by himself. And I hope you guys enjoyed my video. I don't really know what else to say about this guy other than the fact that, it's a very nice figure, but I don't think that it's worth the price. If you really like good arts and crafts, you could probably just do it yourself. You could probably find someone else to do it for you. I mean, there's a few sellers in China that just kind of does it because they're really good at doing bedazzling, and they'll do it for like how much would it be? Like 200 bucks would be like $30 maybe USD to just kind of put crystals on. They and crystals included. So yeah, definitely if you're just kind of in it for the hype and for that collectivity. Well, definitely a nice figure to pick up because out of all the figures that are in this kind of bedazzled, it is I say that word a lot. I prefer this guy, and Killer Queen is very, very nice as well, and Gappy would be my favorite. But it is so hard to find and so expensive. So this is from the 2020 release, and I live in Shanghai, so it's a lot easier to get this at a close to retail price. And articulation wise and whatnot, it's the same as the other ones, as a regular Diablo, so that's what you expect. Thanks. Hope you guys enjoyed. Oh, I forgot. These guys also come with like this certificate of authenticity. So you should probably have that in mind when you if you want to buy it, just make sure you guys have this, and the numbering on that matches the number on your box. Thanks.